was for the copper, and the theoretical value was 59 into 10 to the power 6. So now you can see this is 10 times higher than the experimental, right? Because 53 and 59 nearly 10 times higher, slightly more than 10 times. So that means classical prediction was wrong. So this was first clue that classical theory will not work. Second, what about the dependence of resistivity or conductivity on temperature? So dependence of resistivity, please go back to the expression and check here. That remember, conductivity is 1 by resistivity, right? So resistivity is proportional to T to the power half. If I write down sigma is equal to 1 by rho, then rho is proportional to T to the power half. Yes or no? But according to experiment, if you plot the experimental data on copper, it is showing that resistivity is proportional to T, but theory is telling resistivity is proportional to half. So T to the power half is a parabola and T to the power 1 is a straight line. A parabola is very different than straight line, right?
Yes.
So theory will not work. So classical theory was therefore a failure. Please understand this way, that T to the power 1 is a line, is a linear graph. T to the power half is a parabola. So if you plot experiment with theory for resistivity, I'll be doing some cheating with you. I'll be just making it row, but you have to draw your new. So if you look at the experimental value, green line I'm limiting. So if you look at the experimental value, they fit to the like this. But if you look at the theoretical value, it is, which is not good. So they are very different, right? So therefore, there was a doubt on the theoretical prediction, and this is theory, okay? This is theory, because this is T to the power half. T to the power half is a parabola, right? So, you know T to the power half is a parabola or not? Can you prove T to the power half is a parabola? Please prove on your paper, without drawing, that T to the power half is a parabola. I want to see if you know high school mathematics. Proof. Two lines, just two lines proof. I give you 1 minute time. Within 1 minute, prove it. That T to the power half is a parabola. Because in the high school, when someone comes for teacher, I take the interview. I first ask, what you will teach? They say, sir, I will teach mathematics. Good. Very good. Prove it. No calculator. This is the problem. That's why Einstein said, all filled with technological idiots. Always calculator, mobile phone, and so on. In the shop, you go, ask the price, they will do in the calculator. So like this, in the Chinese shop. Hey, how much is the mobile? Like this. This is not, you have to tell. Well, have you done? How many of you have done? That means you don't know. If you do it, 1 minute it will come. Well, suppose I write fx, not fx, it would be complicated, at high school, I have to go this way. So suppose I write y is equal to x to the power half, right? Then I can write down that, suppose I write y proportional to x to the power half. Then I can write down y square is equal to cx, right? So I can write this as y square is equal to 4ax. What is that? That is a parabola, right? High school? So therefore, if y is x to the power half, this is a parabola. Yes or no?
Yes.
When you see this, then you say, oh, y square is equal to 4x in the high school study, right? It is as simple as that. So that's why mathematics and physics mark this. So it is said that if you want to know good physics, first take many courses on mathematics. Otherwise, you will not be a physicist. You will be just a dumb parrot. If you learn physics without mathematics, you are a dumb parrot. Meaning a parrot, whatever you say, they will tell. Slang, good, anything. Because they don't have logic. Same thing. To develop the logic of physics, you need to learn mathematics.